writing down and making lessons out of all of this material that I have covered recently, because I can see the value of it. Because once you get renewed in the area of God's love and God's concern, you know, and all of those scriptures become a part of you, when you can pray them, when you can pray them in the Spirit, sing them, they will begin to become a part of you, and it will make your life really, really complete. It will just make you as happy as you will ever get.
Amen.
Amen. That's what these scriptures are designed to do.
Yes.
To make you really happy.
Yes.
Amen. Make you feel that God is what? Not only by your side,
yes,
but God is what? He is for you. He's
yes.
with you. He's in you. And he's there to meet every need according to his riches and glory, which is in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. The Lord's greatest attribute is benevolence. Amen. God's greatest attribute. I know God is many things. He's holy. He's righteous. He's good. Amen. He's a God of mercy. God of, some say he's a God of judgment. Amen. God is many things. He has many, many, many attributes. But the greatest attribute is the attribute that he is what? He is love. He is love. How many can say amen? He is love. Amen. So I believe that when we say God is gracious, that means he's disposed to show in favor. Amen. I just believe that as we begin to share with people in the realm of their health, nutrition, then we need, and we also have the responsibility of sharing with people that God loves them.
Amen.
And that God wants to help them in every area and realm of their
yes.
lives.
Yes.
Spiritual area,
yes.
is that right?
Yes.
The physical area, their emotional area, and
yes.
in the area in the realm of their family and home. Amen. Praise God. So I just believe that when we can lift the Lord up as being very compassionate, being the Lord that's touched with the feelings of our infirmity,
yes.
I believe that he's going to get somebody's attention.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. I'm working on a whole lot of information that will just walk people through. Most of this information is already in your possession. That you can just walk yourself through all of the promises and provisions God has made for you in terms of your healing.
Yes.
Praise Amen.
Praise.
See, all of this reflects God's what? Mercy.
Yes.
Amen. He's disposed to what? Showing favor. All of the illustrations and examples we see in the Old Testament, how God brought forth 2.5 million people. Scripture says he brought them forth out of Egypt. You know, whenever you get 2.5 million people at least together, you're gonna have how much? You're gonna have a whole lot of what sick folk.
Yeah.
You're right. You can have 10 in this place, and you're gonna find 2 or 3 or 4 out of that 10 is gonna have what? Some type of what? Problem.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
But the scripture says he sent his word and he what?
Healed
them.
Yes.
Amen. That shows a loving and kind the Lord, doesn't it?
Yes.
He sent his word. He told Moses exactly what to do. And when they carried out the command of Moses, the scripture says the Lord worked in a miraculous way. He brought them all forth with what? Silver and gold. And there was not one feeble person among their tribes. Amen. All God has to do is to what? Send his word.
That's right.
Amen. Tell the Lord how good, tell people how good he is. Tell people how, amen, how he's a healer. That he's touched with the things you're going through. Amen. Tell them that he's already made provisions for you to be whole. Amen. Tell people that he's already delivered you from the power of darkness. Tell them that he's already redeemed you from the curse of the law. Tell them that he was made sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in Christ. I believe we got a message for the lost. We got a message. Hallelujah. And we just have to find a way, amen, that we can what, get this message over without feeling what? Without they thinking, feeling intimidated, without them feeling, amen, that we're trying to what, push some doctrine off on them that they don't want. I think that we ought to just magnify Jesus. How many can say amen? Amen. Praise God. We have a whole lot of good news to tell folk. And I'll tell you, I'm resigned, amen, to do whatever, use whatever method God leads me to use in order to open the door for me to tell people that God is a healer. If I can get them feeling better naturally, amen, that opens the door for me to what? Amen, get to their what? Spirit. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm happy today. Amen. Praise God. So all through the Old Testament, we see God as a what? Healer. God is a what? Healer. How many believe that God is still a healer? He ain't changed. The only reason maybe you don't see it as, amen, as prevalent as you see people saying that they're with the Holy Spirit is because we have not focused or majored on the healing aspect of our redemption as much as we have majored on what? The spiritual aspect of our redemption. That's the only reason why God doesn't heal as readily as people are saying. But I believe if we can just lift them up as a what? A Lord that's what? Full of compassion. And He still wants to heal today. You know, the covenant He made with Israel lasted 450 years in succession. God was their only healer. They didn't have no doctors, no physicians, no surgeons. Nobody to cut nothing out of their bodies. No pharmacist, drugstores. All they had was what? Right. The Word of God. And He prayed every time. Amen. They got sick and diseased. Amen. God told somebody, amen, gave them instructions as what to do. He sent His Word and He what? Healed them. That happened 430 years. Amen. Praise the end of the session. Amen. How many believe that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever? Hallelujah. Praise God. So God is still a God of compassion. He's disposed to show in favor. Amen. Praise God. And how many can praise God for the favors that you have received? Scripture says God is rich in mercy. Amen. He is rich in mercy until everyone that calls upon Him.
Yes.
Amen. He's rich in mercy. Until everyone that calls upon Him. Just think about that. Everyone that calls upon God for any particular need, He's what? He's rich in mercy.
Yes.
Amen. How many glad that you have a compassionate Heavenly Father that's rich in mercy? And everyone that calls upon Him. The Scripture says, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yes,
shall be saved. Amen. Praise God. And the Bible says, whosoever believeth in Him shall not be condemned. Now, I want you to make sure that you have all of these scriptures because I'm going to be giving you illustrations of these scriptures really very shortly. Amen. Michael 7:18. Amen. We're just stressing the fact that the Lord's greatest attribute is benevolence. Amen. He's full of compassion. Let me just read this. F.F. Bosworth says that the most conspicuous, and that's the most readily seen, that big word, amen, might trip some of y'all. The most conspicuous, the most readily seen statement in the scripture about our Heavenly Father are the declarations concerning His love, His mercy, and His compassion. And that's what I'm about to share with you this morning. Amen. In other words, the part of the scriptures that stand out more than all of the others are the scriptures that focus on God's love, God's mercy, and God's compassion. Those are the scriptures that stands out among, amen, all others in the Bible. This is what he says. There's no note that can be sounded concerning, amen, God's love that would so inspire faith as this one. In other words, this is the area of a realm of the scripture that inspires faith more than any other area. Now you need to know that, because that's the reason why I'm majoring on these scriptures that I'm about to give you. I'm majoring on them because, you know, in the morning time I just say these things to God. Whoever is here is going to hear them too. Amen. I just say these things out because it just builds me up, amen, big time. Amen. There's no other part of the word that will inspire your faith, amen, more than scriptures that focus on God's love and God's compassion. To me, it makes sense, what, to spend as much time as necessary, amen, feeding on these scriptures, speaking these scriptures to God, praying these scriptures, and if you can find a way to sing them, amen. Amen. Praise God. Now, this is what he said. In his revivals, he saw faith rise mountain high when the truth of God's present love and compassion began to dawn on the hearts and minds of the people. Amen. In other words, he said when he, in his revivals, in order, whenever he wanted to see faith rising to the highest peak where people could receive healing or any miracle at any point, he said that he would just focus on God's love and God's compassion. And he said that this caused the faith of the people rise, amen, mountain high. This is what he said. It is not what God can do, but what we know he yearns to do that builds faith. In other words, it's not what God can. You know, sometimes people say, God is able. Amen. If there's no faith, that's not going to inspire anybody. God is able. The devil knows that. Bible says the devil believes and he trembles. That's not going to be sufficient to inspire people. God is able. That's what sometimes saints just leave it at that. God is able. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm going through this, sister. God is able. That ain't going to do nothing for nobody. All right. Now, we can go up, take it another step further. God is willing. Amen. How many believe that God is willing is a little stronger than God is able? There's a whole lot of things Sister Hill is able to do for me. But the problem is she willing? I have to focus on stuff she's willing. She can do a whole lot of stuff. But I always focus on what? The thing that I know she's what? Willing to do. Brother, amen. Don't you do the same thing? I know Sister Irene, amen, Sister Irene ain't no pushover. But she can talk real fast. She can talk. Boy, she's a good talker. Amen. So the Bible said, well, I don't mean no harm, but then she get to her point. All right. Well, amen. So it's not what God is willing to do that inspires faith so much, but that really helps to know God is willing. But the thing that inspires faith more than any other thing is God yearns to do something. What he yearns to do. That means what he wants. He wants to do. He's willing to do it, and he wants to do it what? Really bad. And he wants to do it more than you want the thing. What? Want the thing done? That's the thing that makes your faith rise, what, to a mountain high peak.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Now, these scriptures are designed to help you to, you know, you can feed on these scriptures, you can talk them to your spirit, you can just deposit these in your spirit by speaking them out loud. You can use them in prayer. You can sing them in prayer. You can just reflect on them. But these are the scriptures that you need if you want to build your prayer life. If you want to build your faith to the point where you can help people, bless people, and inspire them to believe the word. You got to focus on what the point that God, what, not is able, not just willing, but God, what, he yearns. He wants to do it, and he wants to do it what? More than you want the thing done.
Amen.
Amen. Scripture says in 2 Chronicles 16:9, amen, this is the scripture that shows you that God is eagerly desirous of what? Amen, praise God, getting every blessing that he has ever provided to you. Amen, praise God, in his fullness. The Bible says God's eyes are what? Running to and fro. Amen. His eyes are running. Amen. God is just checking everybody out. Anywhere he has an opportunity to release the blessing into a person's life, he's looking and seeking for that opportunity. Amen. He's seeking. His eyes are what? Running to and fro. Amen. Just turn your head both ways. That's where God's eyes are right.
Yes.
And he's looking, he's checking people out. Because he's looking for an opportunity.
Yes.
See, some people won't give him an opportunity because they're just here. Amen. Some of y'all looking at me right now. Amen. You might just be counting sheep. Twiddling your thumbs. Amen. See, the people that were blessed and were healed, that came here, the Bible says they came to what? To hear and to be healed. Everybody don't have ears to hear. Amen. Some of y'all, I hope that I shut this thing down as soon as I can. As soon as, amen. But God's eyes are what? Running to and fro. In other words, he yearns to what? Bless people. He yearns to what? Cause a person's faith, he wants that person's faith to rise up to a peak where he can what? Release his healing power in them. Amen. See, you have to make it possible. You have to be the one that what? Create the environment for God to what? Release his mercies. Although he's rich in mercy. Oh God, 2 Corinthians 1:3. They call him, amen, Paul called him the God of mercies. Amen. Healing is a mercy. Peace is a mercy. Joy is a mercy. Prosperity, what? Is a mercy. Salvation is a what? Is a mercy. Amen. Boy, I tell you, I got a good home. I got a whole lot of peace in my home. Well, this morning, boy, I just said, you know, this prayer meeting will fire y'all up. And it will fire your love, that love thing. Amen. Just getting a little dim. Or just not being demonstrative. Faith, when I said faith without works is what? Dead. If your love needs to be rekindled, if it needs to be revitalized, amen, praise God. What you need is, amen, to get in what? To get in prayer.
Yes.
Amen. And then begin to focus on what? How good God is. Amen. That really helps. Amen. That can take your love to a mountain peak level. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Bible says we are saved or we are delivered by his life. Amen. The more life you have, the more joy you have, the more worship you have. Amen. You know, I feel real proud because I'm taking, amen, we're getting people like Sister Judith.
Yes.
Amen. She don't think that she way up there like a whole lot of folk.
But she got some stuff going for her, and a whole lot of people wait on their God, which they had. Amen. Y'all don't believe this, but when she comes down that aisle, amen, usually she comes in between 5 and 5:15. I'm telling off on her. Amen. Praise God. But let me tell you, but when she comes down that aisle, amen, my soul gets happy. Because I have somebody in agreement with me in the spirit. I can feel her. And, amen, by being around people that's praying the word, amen, she began to pick up a whole lot of the slings, a whole lot of the phrases, a whole lot of the things that we're saying in prayer that makes us really happy. Amen. She began to pick up all of these phrases, and then she began to what? Speak these things out loud. And she began to lift her voice. Amen. And then before you know it, she's around here what? Jumping up and down. And amen. And the Lord has, amen, perfected her ability to pray in the spirit. Amen. Now that is very valuable, because a whole lot of people wish they had the breakthrough that Sister Judy has. Amen. As a result of that, them pains all over her feet and all that. One more, she said, I'm pain free now. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Some of us need to know how to get rid of our pain.
Yes.
Bible says, amen, he bore all of our sicknesses.
Yes.
And he's carrying all of our what? Sorrow.
Yes.
All of our pain.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
That's the way you can get rid of all your what? Sickness and disease.
Yes.
Because the joy of the Lord is what? Your strength. Amen. God's eyes are still what? He's looking for somebody. Amen. That will open. Amen. When they walk down that aisle. He's looking for somebody that will walk down that aisle and come out here with a mind to what?
Pray.
Bible says, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. To me, that's a big deal. Hey, he's nigh unto all of them that would call on him. To me, that's a big deal. God doesn't have no respect of person. Amen. Sister Sherry Brown, amen, a couple of years ago, we couldn't hardly find her, amen, doing a prayer meeting with a search warrant. You know I'm telling the truth. But now, amen, I don't know if a single person, amen, other than these that I'm kind of pointing out, amen, that is so anointed.
Yeah.
I never dreamed this lady would be anointed like this.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen. So that's the scripture I want you to meditate on. 2 Chronicles 16:9. His eyes are running. Amen. To me, that seems like somebody that's what eager to pour his blessings upon what somebody that have a need, provided if they will what make the way for him to do it. Amen. How many got that scripture? How many got that scripture? Amen. I want you to turn to Psalms 84, verse 11. Now, these are scriptures I've given out from time to time, but I'm so excited about these scriptures this week because the Lord gave me a tune for every one of these scriptures. He gave me a song, sister. Amen. I believe if I can sing it, you can sing it. Amen. You can sing it better than me. Amen. Praise God. But sing these songs. Sing these songs. Are we supposed to sing songs and hymns and what? Spiritual songs? Are we supposed to do that? Amen. I'm teaching you how to what? Build yourselves up on your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. You can pray in the Holy Ghost in tongues. You can pray in the Holy Ghost in your known tongue. Pray the word. Be anointed. Put everything you have in. You can pray in the spirit, even pray in your own tongue. How can you say amen? Just pray the word. Amen. What did that scripture say? The Lord God is a what? Sun and shield. He gives what? Grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that what? Amen. No good thing will he withhold from them that what? Amen. So I want you to see that God is not a withholder. But the Lord God is a what? Sun and shield. Does the sun withhold its light and its strength and its ministry? Does the sun withhold that? Every day, most days, what happens? That sun is what? Coming on out. Amen. How many can say amen? And we all know what the sun does, right? Hey, hallelujah. It has a variety of what? Ministries. Amen. It's a sun and a what? Shield. Amen. The Lord God is a what? Sun and a shield. Amen. What would he shield you from? Amen. Bible says the angel of the Lord encampeth what? Round about. Them that fear them. He's keeping, even he's shielding you from what? From all the forces around you that comes to what? Steal, kill, and what? Destroy. And as long as you, amen, can keep the door open. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And stay connected with God who wants to pour these blessings out upon you. The Lord will always be your what? Shield. Hey, yeah. Hallelujah. He gives what? Grace and what? Glory. How many know that grace is something that everybody won't move off? Grace is God's, amen, it's Christ's, God's riches at Christ's expense. Is God doing for you what you never will ever be able to do for your own self? Yeah. Amen. Somebody said it this way: grace is the total sum of all that God has done for you in Christ. Everything that God has provided you. How many believe it's peace in the Lord? Joy in the Lord. Salvation. Healing. Health. Strength. Power. Anointing. Love. All of these things God has already provided for you. Amen. We can see under the old covenant. Amen. That how all of these things were actually made available through the seven compound names of what? Jehovah. Every need that you would ever have, God had already made provision from the foundation of the world. Amen. He purposed that Jesus would come into the world. That's the reason why the scripture says God didn't withhold his own son, but he delivered him up for us all. How shall we not with him freely? Amen. Freely. God still shows us that what? He is eagerly, amen, desirous of what? Pouring out upon us every blessing that we need to fulfill our lives in whatever realm, whatever area that we have any particular need. How many know that God is good? Amen. Amen. The Lord is, amen, amen. He gives what? Grace and what? Glory. The sum total of all that God has done for us in Christ, amen, is ours. Amen. Praise God. Amen. And everything that God is presently doing for us through the Holy Ghost. How many know that God is doing for us, amen, right now? He's doing some things for us through the Holy Ghost. So this dispensation of grace is just phenomenal. God can do a whole lot more for us since Jesus has come. The Bible says he was full of grace and what? Truth. He's able to do a whole lot more for us now than he what? Was able to do us under the old covenant. We have a better covenant based on what? Better what? Promises. Amen. You know, some of us would do pretty good if we could just enjoy what they enjoyed on the old covenant. How many remember Job got healed under the old covenant? Is that right? Amen. Praise God. We always talk about how Job, amen, how Job suffered, but Job didn't stay sick. The Bible says God turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. See, God released his grace when Job, praise God, did what God told him to do. Hey, Job had to repent because what? He had turned bitter. Amen. He had gotten to a point where he had placed himself above God. He said, I ain't done nothing wrong. When God said, amen, when God knew that Job had sinned with his mouth. Because Job had what? Amen. Job said, the thing that I have feared most has what? Come upon me. How many can say amen? Job was talking what? Fear. He was talking negative. Amen. You keep on talking this negative junk. Amen. You're going to what? You're going to, amen, you're going to what? End up getting what you say. Is that right? So Job talked all this negative talk because every time, amen, the Bible says in Job 1:5 that Job continuously, amen, mentioned that he was fearful of his sons, amen, praise God, sinning before the Lord, amen, by not observing God's word because they were sons and daughters that liked to party. And they had these feasts consistently. And Job was always concerned that they were going to what? Blow it. And God would what? Praise God. Would judge them. So Job just consistently talked about his fear. And one day, the thing that he feared greatly came upon him. But he didn't detect that negative words. The Bible says, praise God, hallelujah, the power of life and death is in your what? Tongue. You are snared by the what? Words of your what? Mouth. You're taken captive by the words of your mouth. So his tongue, amen, got him into a mess and caused a whole lot of adversity and calamity to come upon him. And Job didn't think he had what? Disobeyed God at all. And he was speaking about how self-righteous, how righteous he was, how holy. I ain't never missed it. Man, what you talking about? You're accusing me. I ain't never missed it. So Job had to what? God had to what? Amen. He had to what? Bring him down. He went down to skin and bones. But when Job, amen, met God in judgment. Amen. Job said, Lord, if I could just meet you in court, I will settle the issue. I ain't done nothing wrong. I'm holy. I'm righteous. I never missed it. I never sinned. But when he met court, he said, look, God, if I can just meet you in court, I'll settle this score. I'll show you, tell you, amen, that I am what? I'm righteous. But when he met court, God asked him 186 questions. Where were you when I invented the rain? Amen. Praise God. Amen.